Thank you very much, Dinos, for giving me the opportunity to tell a little bit about the work we did in the socioeconomic work package. Our work package is very good represented here. I think about 10 people from the socioeconomic work packages are here. So if you have questions, please ask the other ones as well who are in the room. I'm from Wageningen Economic Research, and I was the grant work package leader of this work package, so I'm asked to do this presentation, and Lewis will do the next presentation about the more technical issues, because that's not my field of research. I'll tell more about the market research and the business models that we developed during the project. So these are all the partners in the project. So if people raise their hands there from the socioeconomic work package, these are the people who worked on the on all the research projects that we did. And we did a lot. We had 31 deliverables in 4 years in four work packages. So that's quite a lot. And we did, we finished about 10 scientific papers. And there are about 5 to do yet. So we had a very high production in this project. What did we do? At first, we looked at the institutional context and the organizational context. So is there a market for new agricultural products in the EU? Are people open for new products in the EU? That's the first step that we took. We developed new products. You've seen them in a lot of presentation already. I'll show the overview of most products that we developed in this project and tell you more about that. And we did a lot on consumer research. So we looked at how new products could be communicated in the market and how they could be communicated effectively. And the last bit of the project, which is a very important one, was on business modeling, feasibility of the species, and strategies for market development. So that's what we did. And if you look at how we built the project, then you see that we didn't do all the parts of the project for all species. The market analysis was done for all species. So more in general, is there a market for new aquaculture species? But in all the other steps of the project, we had to choose species. Not because we wanted or that species were not interesting to do something about, but it could be either practical reasons or it could be scientific reasons, because every new species that you bring in is a new variable that you bring in. And the more variables you have, you know, as a scientist, the more consumers you have to interview. So, because your cells have to be big enough for analysis. So we had to make choices. And this figure shows what species we did, research with. So for the new product development, we had these four products because these were available when we did the product development. The business modeling we did for the same products because we had the data available of the sensory test and all other tests before for these four products. And in communication, we could only choose two species. So we chose a species where we had good packaging materials for, and where we had good picture materials from the business models and for the new product development. And in the online market test, we could only do one product, because otherwise we should have interviewed thousands of consumers all over Europe, and we didn't have enough budget to do that for all the species. So that's the build-up of the socioeconomic work package. And as I said, we started off with the market analysis. Are consumers in the EU interested in new species? And the answer is yes. A segment of consumers in the European market is really interested in new species. It are the more involved consumers and the more innovative oriented consumers that are most open for new aquaculture products. And the second group are more traditionally fish buying consumers that are interested in new species. But these consumers are more interested in the products that they already know. So if you bring in a new species, you have to explain to this group of consumers what could be done with this species and what it resembles like. And I'll come back to that later. When we started the project, sorry, I go a little bit too fast, I had the wrong button. When we started the project, the social element was also very important. Are people open to start new aquaculture in Europe? And we learned from the business-to-business buyers at companies, at retailers and mongers, that they are very open to try new species and to pick up new species in their assortment. So from the social viewpoint, they could get much more employment in the new species. And we looked to certification. And in the certification, we learned that there are some grounds for certifications that are equal in different countries, but that each buyer has his own certification needs and wants. So it's not that you do one type of certification for this new species and that you can do it in the market and everywhere and sell your product everywhere. So this is what I told about the new types of consumers, that the ones who are very involved and are very innovative are the most interesting market segments. And we developed new products. We developed a lot of new products. And you see that the products we developed are a little bit different from the products that you normally see in a store, like a normal fish fillet or a fish fillet that is smoked, that kind of products, the products that people are familiar with. We saw in our tests that consumers are very open for convenience products for fish. What we saw too is that further processing of products, and especially for fish, are very interesting new ways to sell fish. This tube of pike perch fish was not interesting from the viewpoint of the producers when we presented this at the species workshops that Pascal organized. They were looking like, oh my gosh, you shouldn't do that with my pike perch. I want to have fillets or the high value products. But what we saw in the consumer research is that consumers are very interested in such products, more processed products that are very convenient and where they don't have to process it themselves. Okay, our tube is not very nice. A white tube is not the most beautiful packaging, but if you make a good packaging for a product like that, it could be very interesting. As well as the more luxurious product, and that's the high end of products that you see in the supermarket. What we call the top end of products that you see with Christmas or Eastern or that kind of products. You could make products with fish like that as well. And consumers are interested in such products. Yeah. And we made business models per product. And as you see, it's a full picture, so I don't do everything. You can see it in the handout afterwards. But what I would like to explain is that this business model, it's called a Canvas business model, shows all the important elements that are needed to sell a product. So it's not only for fish, we applied it for fish in this project. All the presentations you have heard this morning are on the left side of this picture. So how do you produce larvae? How do you produce juveniles? What problems you have in nutrition? And that have to be solved. These are all issues that have been solved in the technical work packages. What we do in the right side of the project is looking at the most important issues that are interesting for consumers. What do they want to know? And how should you sell the species? And maybe you see issues that should be in, but these are, in our opinion, the most important things. For example, gray mullet, you know there is a market already for this species because certain segments of the market are very familiar with the species, especially Muslim women know recipes for this species and they have used this species for a very long time. So these are, back to the picture I had before, the traditional buyers of this product. So you have already a segment for this product in the market, and there are already premium products to get added value out of this product. So for market penetration, it's only important that you get the right segment in the market to sell this product. That's different, for example, for greater amberjack. Some people know the wild species, but not everybody. We even learned in the business-to-business interviews that a lot of buyers of supermarkets don't know this species, even not in the Latin name. So for this species, you have to position your product. Maybe you think everybody knows this species. No, not everybody knows it. So you have to make sure to buyers how it's going to be positioned in your store. How should it be presented? What we did in the online market test is that we said it resembles tuna. Tuna is the closest competitor. And consumers appreciate that. They say that you say it's some kind of tuna helps me to make the choice or not the choice to buy the product. So for Meager, for example, consumers are very interested in convenience products. And what we learned from the product development is that Meager is a product that's very suitable to make further processed products of. And you can get added value of that as well, because now the further processed products are not that interesting in margin, but there are in other product groups products that are further processed that people make much more money with. For example, in hams, if they are seasoned, they ask 20% a higher price for meat. So for Meager, you could think about products like that as well. And the burgers you saw before, that was presented by Alicia as well, this kind of products could be targeted to consumers, to children, because fish sticks are still an important market in Europe. Unilever get big with it, earns a lot of money with it. So if you look at communication, there comes other issues coming, and this is especially for fresh fillets and smoked fillets, that kind of products. You learn that the country of origin is very important for consumers. A lot of consumers give added value to a fish aquaculture product if they know it's produced in Europe. Consumers want to know where it comes from. And if you use additional nutrition and health claims, this gives added value to consumers as well. And I wrote after it, ego goes for eco, what means that if consumers have the feeling they buy a much more healthy or nutritional product, then they want to pay more money for it because there's something in it for themselves. It's not only for the environment and for the sea and for nature. if it's better for people themselves, they want to pay more. And what we learned from the interviews with the consumers, with the retail buyers, certification is important. Consumers don't look that much to certification, but if the retailer thinks certification is important, they follow the retailer. And that's not only for fish, that's for all kinds of products. If the retail buyer says this is important, then they buy it too. And ultimately, so that's the lowest part of my model that I presented in the beginning, we did an online market test. And in this test, we presented a lot of products and we asked consumers to buy for themselves, for their own household, what they wanted to have. There were no real deliveries, but there was a real online market test. Market's website was presented. And what you see is that consumers need the positioning. So we have to learn much more about that, about how consumers position fish. We learned already a lot in this project, but there's a lot to be learned more about how consumers look at species and how they compare them to each other. And we see that's not strange, that innovative consumers try the new products first. But if you think back to the figure that I presented in the beginning, there was not much difference between the traditionals and the other groups. So if consumers are involved, that didn't do as much as whether people are innovative oriented. You should communicate that the product is environmentally friendly in some of the countries. So not in all countries. It helps to say that it's better for the environment, what I just said. So for most people, it helps much more than that to say that it is nutritionally or healthy. And only in Spain, the price promotion helped. In all the other countries, price promotion wasn't that important in how they choose the product. And what we learned is that Southern European consumers are much more open for the new species. And Ed, our colleague, made a great model in where he learned that the market penetrations could better be done country by country instead of doing a global or pan-European strategy for the new species. So we did a lot as I started. We did 31 deliverables. But there are also things that we still have to do before selling the fish like in the picture is the case. We have to do much more on sensory positioning, on market tests, on perception of aquaculture in general and how these species fit in it. So we, as a socioeconomic group, would like to do much more in a Diversify 2 project to find more out more about the species and the products. And we enjoyed working in this project. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Emma. Indeed, you've done a lot, and over the years you have impressed us with the types of answers that you come up with and kind of information that you come up with. And hopefully we'll have a Diversify 2 to continue together. So any questions for Emma? Yes.
It is just a comment because you have avoided to comment the business plan for Pipers.
Oh.
So can you comment it?
Sorry, Dan.
You have forgotten to comment the slide concerning Piper's business plan.
Oh, the Piper's. Oh, that was I forgot that one. Meager. Oh yeah. Oh, I forgot that one. Oh, you're important one.
Well, they all look the same. So.
Yeah, they all look the same, so I forgot it. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. What is important for the pike perch escape. What is important for the Pike Perch is that it has a neutral taste, and it's especially a product that is well known as wild species in the middle of Europe. So there is already a market for this product, and a lot of producers we saw in France are already producing it. So the only thing that we found in our sensory test that some of the products had an earthy flavor, and that had to do with the way they were slaughtered, because if they were slaughtered properly, then this earthy flavor was not there. So it was a very wanted and good evaluated product in the market. So we think that Pike Perch has a good future in the market as well. So of all the species that we looked at, most of the species have a good potential in the market. The only thing with Pike Perch is that the margin is not interesting yet, and your neighbor was telling about the reasons this morning, and you also, Pascal, the cannibalization and the feed prices and the different feeds that are used are not optimal yet to get a good revenue for the product yet. But as soon as these two issues are solved, this could be a very economically interesting species as well.
When you say the value proposition customizable size, what does that mean?
Where do you see that?
The value proposition like free customizable size. I mean, why is this different from other species? What does it refer to, you know?
For the Pike Perch, I have to think about the most important thing is that you could have different types of products with it. And it's you could customize the size of the product probably on how far you grow them out. I think the company said something about that. Ed, do you remember?
Are they different sizes?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So that the product is still of good quality if you have different sizes of fish. I think that was it.
Yeah, but I would like also you to comment the previous.
Yeah.
Microphone.
Yeah, this one. Yeah. For greater Amberjack, consumers really liked it as an alternative of tuna. We saw that in the market test. This is a product that has gone farthest in what we've done. And even I have to think about the percentage, but 25% out of my head of the consumers bought in the online market test Greater Amberjack, which is for a new product that people hardly know, is a really high percentage of trial. So this is a very interesting product with a very good margin. My colleague Robert has done a financial feasibility study together with Nikos, and the results are to be presented next week. But for this species, you have good margin as a farmer. You have a good product with lots of opportunities in the retail, and you have a segment in the market that is really interested because it comes close to tuna and doesn't have the environmental issues that tuna has. So, yeah, it's a very interesting species. Oh, you're welcome. Yeah, that's our job. We're the socioeconomics. Are there any other questions? Yeah. I have to do it twice.
Related to Great Amberjack, I think there's a big market in Europe already where it's used by sushi producers. So I wonder, did you test this to sushi or just to consumers? Where you went to the people who make sushi, all the small sushi restaurants who import today Cereola from Japan?
No, we didn't go to the sushi restaurants. The product that has been tested in Europe in all the tests that we did was the filet. So it was only the fillet that we tested. So if you say there is an additional market in the sushi market, that might even give better perspectives. But what we did in the online test was only see the fillet.
Yeah, thank you.
I think the two companies that are producing Seriola alla Landi in recirculation systems, they are supplying almost exclusively the sushi market. That's my understanding. So it's an important customer at this size of the industry now, but not when it gets really, really big. Yes.
Just to explain you a bit, Bjorn, the thing is that we had, I'm not sure if you mentioned it, Hema, we had developed 40 ideas, and from these ideas we were selecting 12 products that were tested to check if it was feasible to produce them at the facilities of that that we had. And from these 12, only 6 were selected for the consumer test. And we chose them from probably Luis is going to explain that more in detail. That's it. I forgot that you are talking now. Sorry.
Yeah, but Luis and Rocio are the people who are here today, and some other people as well in our work package who developed these very beautiful new products. So we try to find new products that were not that familiar in the market yet. And that story's in that fillet for Greater Amberjack, wasn't it?